Schizophrenia is caused by dysregulation of dopamine transmission in the brain. More specifically, hyperactivity of dopamine in the mesolimbic pathway mediates positive symptoms of schizophrenia. On the other hand, hypoactivity of dopamine in the mesocortical pathway causes negative and cognitive symptoms of schizophrenia. Currently approved antipsychotics are antagonists of the dopamine type 2 receptor. These lower dopaminergic neurotransmission. Unfortunately, these drugs are associated with undesirable side effects like uncontrolled muscle movements, drowsiness, weight gain, and metabolic disturbances. These might be serious enough that people skip doses or decide not to take them. Currently available antipsychotic medications are also largely ineffective for the negative and cognitive symptoms of schizophrenia. Moreover, some evidence indicates that the D2 receptor blockade might be associated with worsening of negative and cognitive symptoms. In addition, about one-third of patients do not respond well to current medications. Clearly, there is a need for schizophrenia treatments with new mechanisms and symptom targets. Xanomeline has long emerged as a promising new avenue for treating schizophrenia. Unlike most antipsychotics, xanomeline is devoid of direct effects on dopamine receptors. Instead, it is an agonist of the M1 and M4 muscarinic receptors. So how does it work in schizophrenia? The M4 muscarinic receptor is mostly distributed in the brain. The blue markings on this brain illustration indicate the main locations of M4 receptor expression. The M4 receptor is an autoreceptor on cholinergic afferents that project into the ventral tegmental area, or VTA. Upon activation, M4 receptors reduce acetylcholine release onto VTA dopamine neurons and subsequently decrease the firing activity. This leads to a downstream reduction of dopamine release within the nucleus accumbens. Therefore, there is decreased dopamine transmission and neuron firing without blockade of the postsynaptic dopamine receptors. In an early small exploratory trial involving patients with schizophrenia, xanomeline led to greater decreases in some psychotic symptoms than placebo. It was also observed to improve cognitive parameters. But because muscarinic receptors are found widely throughout the body, creating a drug that specifically targets muscarinic receptors within the brain is challenging. There were dose-dependent cholinergic adverse events of nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, sweating, and excessive salivation. These unwanted side effects are mediated by stimulation of peripheral muscarinic receptors. It was serious enough to halt investigation, despite promising improvements in psychotic symptoms. Over the years, scientists have explored ways to mitigate these issues. When clinical development resumed, scientists combined xanomeline with trospium. Trospium is a muscarinic antagonist that does not cross the blood-brain barrier. Combining xanomeline with peripherally acting antimuscarinic trospium appears to significantly reduce side effects and improve tolerability, while preserving the central nervous system benefits. Clinical trials of the xanomeline-trospium combination are underway. In the latest update, as of December 2023, The Lancet published the peer-reviewed data from the Phase 3, Emergent 2 trial. The findings showed how xanomeline-trospium combination significantly reduces positive and negative symptoms in adults with schizophrenia. Compared with placebo, the xanomeline-trospium-treated group showed a significant 9.6-point difference in mean change in the positive and negative syndrome scale total score. The xanomeline-trospium combination also appears to be well-tolerated. It demonstrated a much lower incidence of adverse effects than just xanomeline alone, with most being gastrointestinal. The xanomeline-trospium success signals a paradigm shift in schizophrenia management. While still in development, the latest advancements indicate its potential to address unmet needs in treating this complex mental illness. As xanomeline targets a different pathway compared to currently available antipsychotics, it could potentially address some limitations of existing medications. And that's it for today's pharmacology video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more pharmacology content.